Hello friends, welcome to the practical session of Power Quality. I am Mr. Somnath Hadpe, working as Assistant Professor in Mathusri College of Engineering and Research Center, Nashik, from the Electrical Engineering Department. So let's start the practical session of the Power Quality. Based on the university guidelines, the Power Quality lab session is of 2 hours per week, which is having 1 credit, and the term work of 25 marks. In this lab session, we are going to perform the following practicals, that is the study of power quality analyzer and measurement of voltage, current, power and power factor using it. Second is measurement of harmonic distortion of various equipment such as UPS, AC, DC drives. Then third, harmonic compliance of Institute as per IEEE 519 standard and sizing of the active filter for it. Then fourth experiment is based on the power quality audit of the institute or the department. In our case, we are going to audit it for the institute. Then fifth is harmonic analysis of transformer for the various conditions like no load, inrush and the full load current. A sixth experiment is analysis of performance of induction motor transformer operated with the sinusoidal supply under the distorted supply conditions supplied by three-phase inverter. The seventh experiment will be, it is on MATLAB simulation, that is the study of harmonic generation sources such as VFD, SVC, STATCOM and FACT devices and harmonic measurement by using MATLAB simulation. And finally, we are going to simulate the transient and the flicker measurement. Experiment number one, that is to study the power quality analyzer, and by using it, we will measure the voltage, current, power and the power factor of any kind of load. So here, for the experiment purpose, we have taken the induction motor as the load. So the first part of this experiment is nothing but the power quality analyzer introduction. So how exactly this power quality analyzer works, its various parts, and how we could take the measurements of various quantities into the power quality analyzer. So basically, the power quality analyzer is nothing but an extensive and powerful set of measurements to check power distribution system. So as we know, there are very certain quantities into the power distribution system, so we just want to separate them, and we just taking the various quantities readings, and we just taking the data in terms of waveforms and in terms of the reading. Some gives the general impression of power system performance out of those quantities. Others are used to investigate specific details. So some quantities might be general and some might be very specific.
Power quality analyzer has various its applications. They are not limited actually. In simple way, we can say the power quality analyzer is capturing the characteristics of power supply and store them into the digital format. Here some applications are discussed, but of course there are so many, we are discussing very few. First of all, it will be used where there is a problem into the power, just like sag, swell, interruption, unbalance, then harmonics, flicker and the DC offset. So whenever there is such a condition where we want to detect, we want to analyze those problems, in those cases we can use the analyzer. Another case is if we're talking about the industrial sector, so various you can say major industries like steel plant, cement industry, then wind farm, and normally in a smart grid study. So these are also some fields where energy analyzer can be used. Then various harmonic producing loads like inverters, then some PV inverters might be there for the interconnection with the grid. Then to detect the various power quality problems related with the grounding. Then another application, we can say there are certain equipments like various loads and where we wanted to study the whatever the behavior of that load under the bad power quality. So in such cases we can use the analyzer. Here for example, we can say some lighting loads are there. In industrial loads we can see CNC machine, basically some motors and the fan or the AC devices.
So here you could see the various parts of the
now let's have a look over the various things which come along with the power quality analyzer. So this is actually the bag which come along with the fluke energy analyzer. This is actually the meter through which we are going to take readings the various manner. So this slots indicates for the current measurement purpose, the whatever the below line, it is for the voltage measurement purpose. So let's have the front panel view first, then we'll go to again to the back. So of course that is power on and off button, menu button, then scope for the to see the various waveforms. Then these are the F1, F2, F3, F4, F5. These are the function buttons which we generally require when we are going to take a readings. Then below that there is a logger button. We'll see its function already in a theory. Then save screen to capture the screen. Then memory to see the previous reading and setup for the various, we can say that the readings for, and this particular button is for the brightness, to adjust the brightness. This is enter. So to enter into the any menu we can go into by using enter button. So here you can closely observe the actual model number for the Fluke 434 second series energy analyzer. Now along with that, of course we need some probes and cables. So first of all, here four ring kind of CTs are come. Now we have to just put those CTs into the conductor. If you observe closely here, you can see one arrow over here. So that arrow indicates the direction of flow of current through the conductor. So here what we have to do is, if you just rotate it, it will come out, this conductor will come out. If we place it back through its slot, go into it, and if you again place it in opposite direction, it will lock. So through this you can insert it through the conductor. How exactly this arrow indicates the direction of the current. So in every practical, now you have to just check the connection according to the direction of conductor. As nomenclatures we had marked here, that is for R phase, then this is for Y phase, this is for B, and this is for neutral on the nameplate. That category 3 1000 volt, then category 4 6600 volt. So basically all these are of category 4 distribution side CTs manufactured by Fluke. Then here you can see this arrow, when it is at a lock position, here when it is at a lock position your conductor is lock, and if you rotate into other side, so here you can see the unlock position. So accordingly we can say we have to match accordingly the position. Now here these are the some color coding strips which we normally require to for the identification of the various phases. Here you can see. Then of course these are the second ends of all those CTs. So these color coding strips are already put over here according to Indian color coding that is R, Y, B, and for the neutral we had used a black one over here. So this slots will directly goes into the connections, like suppose here it is the R phase, already it is mentioned over here. You have to just put like and just rotate it just like a bulb. Then for Y phase, same here, we have to just press it and rotate, that's it. And for blue, B phase, same way, rotate and press. And for neutral, if you closely observe here, then you will find you have to just rotate it, push it, and again lock it. That's it. So we can say here we had already connected all the cities to the power quality analyzer. These are the voltage cords which we directly connect to the conductor, that is R, then Y phase, then B, then neutral, and last one is for the earthing, if it is there in a connection, if you want. And other ends are of these all conductors will go directly at the voltage probe. So we'll start one by one. So you can see here these probes are for voltage. So this red indicates for R phase. So this probe, which is noted by the red indication, red kind of strip here, it will go directly into the L1. Then this Y, that is for next phase, will go into the L2, it is over here in this particular slot. Then for the B, that is third phase, this one, it will go for the L3. So you can see here these connections. As we are not connected earthing over here, so we are not going to connect this conductor. Even we don't require neutral here, because already whatever the readings we are taking, they are on a squirrel cage induction motor which is of delta connected. So ultimately we have to remove this even neutral also while taking the reading. Next part is this Fluke manufacturer's warranty card.
So if you could observe, very first thing is the power analyzer. As here, this instrument, this meter like instrument you are just observing is nothing but its power analyzer. Another is the carrier bag of the power quality analyzer. And this other things which comes with the analyzer as power analyzer charging adapter. As you can see here again, power analyzer various plugs are there. Country to country, these plugs and sockets are vary. Then another thing which comes here is the communication cable. This communication cable is required to plug the analyzer with the laptop so that we can import the reading from the analyzer and convert these readings into various waveforms and the graphs, or various to generate various reports with the one application which is coming along with the analyzer in the CD format. So these rings are nothing but the current transformer rings which comes along with the power quality analyzer. Another part is the color code strips. So you can use these rings for the notation purpose. You can attach them over here because all the cities are looking same. So that's why some color coding rings are there. Then voltage cords. So this particular cord, again here you can observe 5 cords are provided for voltage and 4 cities are provided. 3 for the 3 phases, 1 for the neutral. But here you have to measure the voltage with respect to ground. So that's why neutral and the ground and other 3 phases. Another is phase identification tags. Now these phase identification tags are required again for the identification of various cords that we had connected at the analyzer itself. Now let's go towards the input connection. Suppose if I say here the load is connected at this side, and at this side there is a source or the supply system. So and in between that, what we are going to connecting the power quality analyzer. So here you can see whatever the voltage quads, we are directly connecting them towards the various phases. Suppose if I say this is phase A, B, C, this is neutral conductor and this is ground conductor. So in that case, you can just connect them serially. Here neutral and the ground, they are separately mentioned on the power quality analyzer connection. You need not to bother about the cross connection of the CTs and the voltage connections, because whatever the quads, they have been manufactured such that only current CTs will be put. Those slots are just like a bulb and holder slot, so they only have to insert into that connection only, and the voltage quad will insert into voltage connection only. There should be no cross connection, as the manufacturing of this Fluke analyzer is very beautiful, that you need not to bother about that. Yes, of course you need to take care of the flow of the current. So here into the ring of the CT, there is one arrow direction is already given, so that whatever the ring, it should be placed in such that the direction of that given arrow and the current direction should be in the same direction. So that care you need to take. So if you look on this is the actual photograph for college meter, that is power quality analyzer. So here you can observe the front panel of the analyzer. Here various keys are at the front panel. This is main display screen. Connection, input connection purpose, there is cords are provided, sockets are provided. And you can see here there are some keys are there, that is F1, F2, F3, F4, F5. So these keys are there for the operation purpose. Then one yellow color key is there, that is scope, then menu, logger, then some arrow buttons are there, four arrow buttons in between at the circle manner. Then setup, then memory and save screen options buttons are provided. Then at the last, we can see one green button is there, that is nothing for the power on and off. Then enter button, and this is for the brightness. So you can adjust the screen brightness from this button. If you look at the top of this meter, so here you can observe. So here these five connections are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So they are nothing but the your connections for the voltage quad, that is L1, L2, L3, neutral and the ground. And here you can observe input is written already this analyzer in a charging mode. So in this recent photograph, you can see here there is a charger of this analyzer which is connected here at the input terminal for the power source. And you can observe here these four particular sockets indicates the CT sockets. That means you can connect here the CT cords, that is again phase 1, 2, 3, that is R, Y and B and the neutral point. So initially scope waveform and the phasor. So this mode shows the current, voltage and the power system under study by means of waveforms or the vector diagrams. So by pressing this button, once your connection is done, you just start the load. So you will get the various waveforms by pressing the scope button, so that the analyzer screen will look like this, and it will show you the various current waveforms. Then again, frequency, then phase angle between the voltage and current. So various readings you are able to capture. So let's understand what are the things we can generally measure with the help of the power quality analyzer. So you can say when voltage leads a current, then clamps are connected correctly, use scope waveforms and scope phasor. The clamps are marked with the arrow to facilitate proper signal priority, that is the CT rings. To get general impression of the quality of power system, use monitor. The monitor key displays on the screen with the bar graph that shows quality aspect of the phase voltages. So whether there are some deviations or not, you can check it with the help of the monitor button. A graph changes from green to red if related aspect does not meet the limits. So there are certain standard limits are already set into the analyzer. So you, whatever the limits you are set and whatever the readings you are taking, if they not match, then your graph becomes red. So here you can say there are different keys have different their functions and how we can operate them. So we'll see them one by one. Here we have set the standard according to EN50160 norm. So according to this norm, we are taking the reading. So very first mode into which we are going to take reading of the power quality analyzer is Holt amp hertz mode. So of course this mode indicates itself, it is taking the readings of voltage, ampere that is current, and hertz that is frequency. So by pressing menu button, once you start initially, of course you have to power on the power quality analyzer by using this green button. Once you start it, you will get such kind of screen, that is, and you would get the menu button. After menu button, you will get this screen, that is, it will show you different things like volt, amp, hertz, deep and swell, harmonics, power and energy, flicker, unbalanced, transients, inrush, main signaling, and the logger. So these things, they are there in a display. So initially, of course, we are in a mode of volt, amp and hertz. You have to whatever your blinking strip, it is on the volt, ampere, hertz. And you have to hit the enter button here, then you will get such kind of screen. So of course you are getting here some number, that is 131. That means you are capturing this reading since 1:31. This indicates that your analyzer is on a charging mode, that is the plug kind of symbol. Again, adjacent to that, there is one symbol of the recording. So means what, your readings are going to save. Below that, some run and hold things are there. So accordingly, you have to put this F5, F4. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These 5 blocks are nothing but these 5 keys, that is F1, F2, F3, F4 and F5. So you have to take reading in terms of voltage. You can change it. So for means of various kinds of configuration, star and delta, you have to press F1 here. As these two in blank, so F2, F3 key will not work here. Then trends, you need to check trends. You can press F4. And if you want to pause the reading, so you have to go for F5. So accordingly, everywhere this five buttons are there. So they are nothing but the F1, F2, F3, F4, F5 functions. So for OK, you have to press F5 or the enter button. Next, when you wanted to check the deeps and swell. So of course, once you put a menu, then this screen will be there. Then you can go to deeps and swell by using these center circle buttons. And then you have to enter the enter into that mode, so you'll get such kind of screen. So as we know, deeps and swells are nothing but the sag and swell. So sag and swell definitions are already we have seen in a theory. So similarly, we can go further for the harmonic mode for the power frequencies, multiple of the power frequencies into the sinusoidal waveform. Then power and energy. If some loads is consuming active power, reactive power, then apparent power. So of course, in that case, you can go into the power and energy mode. So here, if you observe kilowatt, kVA, kVAR, PF, then ARMS, VRMS, so current in RMS, voltage in RMS, these readings you can capture. Next is the flicker. So once you press a menu button, so next option will be the flicker. So the analyzer convert duration and magnitude of voltage variation into an annoyance factor caused by the resulting flicker of 60 watt lamp. So there is a deviation, and due to that the lighting is fluctuated, which can capture by the human eyes. So that's why we can say it is quite interesting phenomenon that has been captured. You can capture by means of a flicker. So similarly, if you go further into again enter, so in that mode you will observe this reading, that is the in flicker. Once you enter, so this screen will be there, that is PST and PLT. So these two readings, this PST mode is right now, PLT is not there. So these two modes you can capture. Now the next mode is the unbalance. Whenever you are connected to the three phase supply system, and if there is an unbalance or whatever the phases, they are shifted from each other, not exact into 120 degree. If there is a deviation than that of the 120 degree, so of course there is, we can say they are nothing but the unbalance. So you can check that unbalance by means of a graphical representation over here. Exactly, you can see whatever the phasors of these three phases. Next is transient. Now after this, whatever the modes we are going to see, that is transient, inrush, main signaling and the logger. Now in this mode, the transient is a very short kind of phenomenon which is occurred, which is for a very momentary in the nature, but magnitude is quite high. So such things we can observe. So for that purpose, you need to require the some settings, like which kind of transients you need to measure for what kind of majorities, then the interval in which you want to measure. So after 2 hours or 3 hours, see, because you can connect the power quality analyzer to the system continuously. Even that analyzer has the facility that you can send the readings over the Wi-Fi, so that you can stay at your home, and if it is connected at the load side, it might be whatever the distance between the load and you. So also you can observe the readings at your cell phone or at your laptop. So all the facilities are already provided into the analyzer. Then inrush. So inrush is nothing but the inrush current whenever there is a sudden start of the, suppose, induction motor, which taking the very large current and suddenly. So what kind of a large current it is been taken by the induction motor. So here you can see the graphs of such inrush currents and for what duration that inrush current is there. So that also we can observe. Now next is the mains signaling. So this particular facility is again available into the 435 series kind of analyzer. So here basically main signalings are nothing but with a power frequency of 50 to 60 hertz in a main cable, other signals like a controlling signals are also added into the cable. So whether these signals are working properly or not, for that purpose and we require this main signaling. These main signalings also might be having the frequency range up to the 3 kilohertz, so that frequency should not interfere with the main power frequency signal of 50 or the 60 hertz. So by means of selecting that, you can measure it, and for that range of frequency is 70 to 300 hertz. Then last thing is the logger. Here in case of a logger, you just set some marginal limits, and out of that marginal limit, if your reading goes for a particular period, then logger just capture that and also shows you the instance through which you can capture it. So friends, up till here we just see the different modes of power quality analyzer, how it works in the theoretical manner. So now let's start. In next video, we will go into the lab and actually see how we can connect the analyzer to a particular load, its connection, how we can take a reading, how we can help operate that into different modes of the operation. So let's join the lab. So welcome all of you in the lab session of the power quality. So friends, today we are going to start our first practical session on the power quality. So in this practical, we are connecting our power quality analyzer to the three-phase induction motor as a load, and we are going to measure the various quantities like voltage, current, power and the power factor through the power quality analyzer. So here we will see first of all how we can connect the motor to the supply, and after that we will see the connection of the power quality analyzer. And in final part, we will see how we can capture the various readings from the power quality analyzer. So let's start. Connection for these experiments are very simple. That initially, we are taking the supply from three-phase supply, that is RYB, all these three phases over here. And after that, once we turn the switch on, there will be a supply into this auto transformer. Now this auto transformer's purpose, it's very simple. If we rotate this particular knob, you will get whatever the output voltage here will be vary,
So these are the input terminals for the this 3 poles variable transformer. It is auto transformer actually. And after this, whatever the output you will get through this R2, Y2 and B2 terminals. R1, Y1 and B1 are nothing but the input terminals, as it is written over here. You can see input for the all three phases, and in this case the output for all these three phases, that is R2, Y2 and the B2. So connections are very simple, that from these outputs we are connecting these all three phases to the terminal of the motor, that is the three phase squirrel cage induction motor. These are the conductors. From the output side they are going towards the load. So here is the first of all the current connection for the CT rings, how we connect the CT rings. As we know here, in case of CT ring, this connection can be open and we can close it like this. And here you can observe there is a knob which there is a direction of current. This particular arrow indicates, so whatever the current conductor you are inserting into this ring, it should be flow through this direction. That means the current direction from source to the load. So here we are going to connect it like this, as this conductor is conducting current from source towards the load. So this is for R. As we are taking the reading on three phase induction motor, which is of delta connected in a delta fashion, so we don't require this neutral conductor, so just keep it aside. So again here we're just going to use only three voltage probes, so neutral and the earth, that these two probes has no use, only we are going to use these three. Simultaneously we will have the connection for this R phase, as the red strip is connected here. So we are just connecting it in the very first side, then for the Y here, and for the B it's here. So we did our all the connections for the current and the voltage probes. Now we are going to connect the other ends of the connection to the actual meter. R will be go at the red terminal, the second is for Y terminal, third is for the green terminal. Then similarly for the current rings, again similarly for the current rings, as we seen previously, red, yellow. Of course we are not going to connect this neutral terminal here, because already the motor is of delta fashion. So let's start the supply and we will observe now the readings. Before starting the supply, let's understand what are the different modes of the power quality. So this is the actual connection from the power quality analyzer to the load. So here you can see these voltage probes are connected, and this is the incoming supply, this is the outgoing supply. At the outgoing itself we have connected the voltage probes, and from every conductor, suppose if I say this is the R, then through the red conductor this particular CT is connected, so that this direction indicates the direction of current from the source to the load. And here our motor is connected into the delta fashion. As you can see here, you will not observe a neutral conductor, only three phases are there in a delta manner. So here you can see the motor with the load changing arrangement through this fill. As we know, we can increase or decrease the load. So now if I press this button, that is on, so you will see this screen. So he is asking for SD card format, I'll go for yes. So now it is preparing the SD card. Okay, before that we will see here, it indicates the Fluke for 434 second series. It is the version that is 4.01, manufactured by Fluke. Then user, here we can put our name, that is MCURC College of Engineering Nasik. Then it is indicating today's date, time, three phase configuration. Limits are nothing but the things. Actually, every equipment manufacturer is work on some standards. So here, EN50160, this is universally accepted standard for the measurement. So it has been used. So you can see here, right now it is in a star connection, but as we have already connected the delta motor, so let's go into the setup. So here you can see, here is the setup. For setup, again you have to go for the user references. So here are some things, that is language you can change, phase identification, phase color, battery save, user ID, likewise. Then faculty default, if you want a demo you can have here. Then contrast, if you want to need to increase the screen contrast, format SD card and the back. So we'll go back, we don't have to change these settings, already these settings were done by me, so no need to change. Then manual setup. So in manual setup, what we need to change is the configuration from three phase star to the delta. So in that, when a strip is here, you just need to go for the enter button. So let's see what happened. So now these so many configurations are available here, so you can change by means of these arrow keys. So if you want this one or this, say if you are connected for the single supply, again there are others also, you can say page 2, then page 3. So many such configurations are available. We'll go for page number 1 and simple delta connection, enter. Okay, so he is saying that what kind of delta connection you are using. So here your three phases are indicating red and yellow and then black, and for our case we have taken a black as a C, and ground connection, as ground connection is not used here. Then go to the enter. So here you can see previously the diagram was the star connection, but right now it is of delta connection. So as we changed it, so similarly you can change the frequency, you can change nominal voltage, you can change standard, you can change the configurations of the conductors, CT rings. So here you can see the CT ring configuration is I430TF. So already if you observe the ratings over here, so you can see here the same kind of rating used for the 430 flexi. Okay, so same CTs we are using, our current ratio and the voltage ratio 1:1, so there will be no extra turns are being used. Now you can see the supply is turned on, and we'll just move slowly. Currently the voltage is shown somewhat near about 10 11 10. Then this is delta fashion, and this is in star manner it is showing 23. So this is as we are selected the star mode. This is your frequency for the supply. So let's have the supply at the secondary side. Okay, so now there is a supply, and now we are going to start the somewhat. So we are running the motor right now for this. Let's have some more voltage. So up to the 215 or 230 volt we can increase the phase voltages. These are the line voltages over here, and for a particular phase, for phase A 2.1 ampere current, for phase B it is 2.6, and for phase C it is 2.4. So Right now we are in volt ampere and hertz mode. You can see here. Now if I press that, we are taking the reading from last 2.40-50 seconds. So here recording is already going on. So for any type of load, connections will remain same for all the practicals. We are going to see the same connection. So now you can see the next reading, that is crest factor for every phase, likewise. So if I press the scope button, what will happen? Let's see. So you can observe the waveform for the voltage. So right now you can observe here A to B, then C to A. If you observe closely, it is from B to C actually. So these voltages you can observe. Now you can observe the current also. So currently you need to change the ratio. So for that you have to zoom it. So this is actual current which is taken by the motor for all these three phases. I think yellow phase is not quite well visible. It's okay right now. And you can observe the its phasor diagram also. So you can see here. As you can see, the power factor is very low as these phases are not in phase of each other, isn't it? Now what happened? Let's see here that if I increase the load, what will happen here? So I'm increasing the load. So let's see. Have you observed the changes? That this particular long line indicates the voltage line. This is for current phase, phasor. This is for again red R phase. This is its phasor. They are moving towards each other. Means what? Your power factor is improving, isn't it? That means your voltage and current, they try to come out in one phase. So here you can say, as you just increase or decrease the load, right now I'm decreasing the load, what will happen? Just see. Isn't it? That means now this angle is quite big. That is the angle between voltage and current. If I again increase, so let's see what happens. You observe the angle between voltage and current is less. So already you know this in theoretical manner, that whenever motor is run on its rated load, at that time only it just maintain its power factor well. Similarly on scope, now these are the currents. If I just observe, want to observe for a particular phase, then for phase A, this is my voltage and this is the current, isn't it? So for phase B, same way, voltage and current, two waveforms. For C, whatever the stable waveform, it indicates for the voltage, and whatever it is, we can say fluctuating kind, it is for the current. So right now what we will do, we will just save this reading. So these are the readings for the voltage and the current. So here reading is saved. So measurement 4, with measurement 4 our reading is saved. So okay. So now again we will go for the menu. And right now we are going to see the power and energy. In harmonics practical we will see the harmonic mode. So this is the reactive power that is motor is consuming, and total kilowatt power, it is of 2.42. its KVA is near about 3, and total KVR it is of 1.72. Right now it is running at the power factor of 0.81. If I again release it, you will see there is a decrease in the power factor. Since I am just releasing the load, you can see there is a drop in the power factor. The last reading over here.
So once you take all the readings successfully into the energy analyzer, so you can connect that to your laptop and you can generate such a report in which whatever the file name, it shows measurement number 5, which is you saved into the analyzer. This is the model number of our analyzer, serial number, then firmware version, that is hardware version, then its software version. And after that, he will ask you whatever the recording location, that is we are taking it at the induction motor load. Then client, of course, if we using it for the various locations, you have to put here location and the client name. And in notes, what I mention is to measure voltage, current and power factor of the induction motor by using energy analyzer. It is our title of the experiment. So if you go further, so it will give you the various details, like you are using it in a delta mode with power and energy application mode, then when you start the reading, when you end the reading. So these things is capturing and nominal voltage, frequency. Then these are the details of current and voltage probes. And what we are interested in these various readings of voltage and current for between the phases AB, then BC, then CE. So you can observe here, if you take any particular line voltage, so variation of voltage is there from 364 volt to the 370 volt. In between this range, the voltages were there. As these are the RMS readings, and similarly for the current, current is vary in the range between 2.8 to near about 4. The same way for all the phases. In this were the for the active power, then reactive power. So very detailed analysis you can see here. So the conclusion from this experiment is that we have just measured the voltage, current, power and the power factor from the energy analyzer.